Just a side note before we get into this video, this is my 400th video on this channel. Woo! Now, let's carry on. That was the worst woo I think I've ever done in my life. Everyone, and welcome back to the channel. Today, we're going to be talking about what is a lucid dream, actually. For those of you who are new, my name is Giz Edwards. I am a lucid dreaming coach and an entrepreneur based here in the UK. And on this channel, we delve into the subjects such as lucid dreaming and entrepreneurship and other bits and pieces to make your life more enjoying, fulfilling, and relaxed. Now, with that out of the way, let's talk about what a lucid dream actually is. This is the second video in my playlist of learning to lucid dream, and it's the first question people often ask and get wrong. What is a lucid dream? So I'm going to describe to you a dream, and I want you to tell me if it is a lucid dream. I was in a town. I'm putting on a voice, by the way. I was in a town, not entirely sure where. I noticed that there were lots of birds sitting on the roof of a nearby house. I wanted to know what it was like to be a bird. So I took my arms and flapped them up and down until I lifted off the ground and flew in the air, soared through the sky, wind ripping against my cheek, and I perched next to the line of birds. When on the roof, I saw a view of the sunset and realized that the sun was a bluish color. I grabbed a feather from the bird next to me and dipped it into my pocket to reveal orange paint now on the feather. I painted over the sun to turn it from its bluish hue to a brilliant orange color. I knew that this was amazing, and I was unsure if anyone had ever experienced this before. I doubt it. Now, was that a lucid dream? I'm going to give you a little time to answer. Okay, moment over. No, it was not a lucid dream. That was an example of dream control without lucidity. And this is where most people are mistaken. Lucid dreaming has nothing to do with dream control. It's everything to do with whether or not you know that you're dreaming. They are separate things entirely. You can have dream control in both lucid and non-lucid dreams, and you can also have a lucid dream with or without dream control. They are not the same. Here's another dream scenario. I was in a bathroom, alone, cleaning my bathtub. I realized that I must be dreaming, as I cannot clean a bathtub usually, as I'm allergic to bleach. I carried on cleaning. That was a lucid dream. I realized that I was dreaming, and control had nothing to do with it. And that is a genuine story, by the way. I did have a lucid dream like that, and I am allergic to bleach. The best explanation for what a lucid dream is actually appeared on the first page of the search results of Google. When I Googled, what is a lucid dream? It was the first result. And the explanation is from a website called Healthline, and it reads thusly. Lucid dreaming happens when you're aware that you're dreaming. You're able to recognize your thoughts and emotions as the dream happens. Sometimes you can control the lucid dream. You may be able to change the people, environment, or storyline. This type of dream control could potentially reduce nightmares and anxiety. Well, that's easy for you to say. I'll leave a link in the description box to the full article. It's interesting read. But with this knowledge in mind, you may come to the conclusion that you've actually had a lucid dream in the past, but you didn't know what it was because you didn't have the understanding or the classification of what a lucid dream actually is. So in summary, a lucid dream does not equal dream control. A lucid dream equals knowing that you're in a dream. And that's it for this video. Nice and short and sweet. Be sure to subscribe because we're talking more about lucid dreaming next Monday. And for those of you who are subscribed, I'll see you then.
Bye.
And anxiety.